Today is a day for us to celebrate in India very much, and maybe also most of the Europe, because the sun goes down to the Capricorn, and from Capricorn it then comes to Tropic of Cancer. When the sun comes on this earth back, then all the creativity of the Mother Earth starts acting, and she creates such beautiful things like flowers, such nice things, nourishing things like fruits, and fulfilling things like foods. She makes our eyes cool down with the greenery she has, and the way she blesses us is manifold with the advent of the sun. In the same way, now that the sun of Sahaja Yoga has risen and is coming to the zenith, and it has definitely shown you the result on the earth principle, that is the your Muladhara, and the creative power of that Muladhara, which is the Kundalini, has been rising and rising and rising and opening your being and showing the results in your lives. It has made your lives very beautiful. It has made your life very joyous and very happy. Now we are at a point where we have to trigger a new jump, a new flight we have to take. And for this flight, we have to see that we really become very light in our ideas, in our thoughts, and in our conditionings. We are so much full of conditionings. All kinds of conditionings are on us. They're so deep that sometimes I fail to understand human beings. I just don't understand how they get stuck to things which are of no value, which have no sense, and they get lost. In this higher jump that we are going to take, many will be left behind as a result, those who won't be able to come out of that. So at this stage, I have to request you that you should really fully dedicate yourself to meditation and surrender yourself to collectivity. And every day you must think in the evening, what have I done for Sahaja Yoga? What have I done for myself? Please try to understand that there is a very big jump we have to take. It is to be triggered. And for that, I would like you to be ready, to be absolutely prepared. Because in this jump, many might be lost and many might be just left behind because they could not get over their conditionings. The conditionings are of various types, as you know very well, of ignorance, blind faith, and all other things that we have gone through. Also, we have conditionings of our country, of our race, of our styles, and so many other things by which we judge others. But we have to judge ourselves, that are we in a search culture or not. If you are not in the search culture, then it's going to be very difficult that you'll board the ship which is going to take us off. I have to just warn you that later on you should say that, Mother, so many were left behind. If you find anybody is leaving left behind, please try to help that person. Please try to correct that person, and with clear ideas, and with clear voice, and with clear-cut instructions. If you really find that somebody is going down, you better warn. I am telling you all today, because you will be departing, that you should look after your fellow men, Sahaja Yogis, and tell them that this is a very crucial time, and at this time, none of us should just take for granted Sahaja Yoga. All other things are just a kind of an illusion, that you feel that the worldly things are all right, or with the worldly things you can manage. God doesn't care for people who are rich, or people who are well off, or people who are poor. What He sees, what richness you have got of spirituality. He doesn't bother about your education, of your degrees, of your pompousness, nothing of the kind. What He sees, how innocent you are, and how much you have worked for Sahaj Yoga, what you have done for God's work. So all these priorities have to be changed, and one must understand that Sahaj Yoga judges you on a very subtle level. So in this last judgment, now, as many people have been judged as good people, very nice people, but still, for the second jump that you are going to have, we have to be very careful that maybe some of you who think in their heart they are Sahaj Yogis but are not, may be left behind. So it is important that the sun has risen and now it has gone to the zenith. And at the time of its zenith, one has to be very careful, because the same sun which has started making this beautiful greenery all around us may scorch with its heat many of them. So be careful, and one has to be all the time under the guidance of Sahaj Yoga to understand what is wrong with us, what is making us so heavy, what is making us so difficult. So far, I'm very happy that whatever I've been telling you and whatever I've been guiding you, you have accepted it very calmly and sweetly, and that you have tried to imbibe it in your lifestyle. Actually, after some time, I don't think I'll have to tell you anything. You will get your own light to see for yourself what is right and what is wrong. But still, I would say, for all the Western people especially, that you must open your heart. In the puja, in the music, in anything, just see that you open your heart. If you cannot open your heart, this won't work, because this works through spirit which resides in your heart. So please try to open your heart for everything. All your conditionings, all your ego will disappear when you decide that I have to open my heart to Sahaj Yoga. May God bless you.